Hey everybody, welcome to The Bottom Line. I'm Mike Nolan. Tonight we have another tutorial in LumaFusion, but not just that, we are also going to have a bit of an introduction slash tutorial with the wonderful pro art app, Procreate. You know, it's hard to believe that we haven't even finished week 6 here, and yet we are shooting right now our 15th video to you already. As I brought out in the last video, the response has been great, and we just want to say, if you get anything out of this video, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. All you have to do is hit subscribe to the tribe, hit that top bell notification, and you'll be notified of all future videos, because they are coming. Just a quick note on the tribal population, we are now at 68, so we're still looking for our first 100 tribal elders. Okay, enough of that, let's get on with the tutorial. Alright, so as you know, we've already explored how to create a banner. Tonight we're going to explore that just a bit further and a bit more creatively, if you know what I mean. And we're going to do that with the cooperation of a few apps. Now, quick note on creativity here. I gotta let you know, I work better if I have a team of apps that work well together. And so these are a few apps that I have found that work very well together, putting together my content in a more creative way here on YouTube. Tonight, we're going to utilize the capabilities of LumaFusion and demonstrate a very simple technique in Procreate. Just as an introduction, nothing more, because we're going to explore Procreate further, trust me. But tonight we're just going to use basically one simple tool and the basic capabilities of Procreate as we look at it through the eyes of LumaFusion. Okay, so as you can tell, I am in LumaFusion. I've put my monitoring screen at full size, but I still have my editing capabilities with my 12.9-inch iPad Pro with a magic keyboard and a wonderful little corner hub. So what I've done, as you've seen in past videos, is created a screen recording, right? Now I've taken that screen recording and brought it into LumaFusion. Why? Well, I want to isolate one particular frame of a family vacation that I've used as my banner on my YouTube channel. Now, if you take a look, I've isolated the frame here, haven't I? And I've double-clicked and I've brought us into the editing window. Once you're in the editing window, you have 5 options down below. Let's take a look at those. You can go to fit to frame. You can go to reverse. Good for reversing action, if that makes more sense. And of course, it has stabilization. And you don't want to overuse this, but if you've done your very best to stabilize video and it just needs a touch, stabilization is wonderful. Let's take a look at number 4. Now, this is a very familiar window, but see, we've isolated one frame and only the photo itself. So we don't see an audio file down here, but that's where it would be if it had an audio clip attached to it. But the place we want to be at is the 5th option, and that gives us color correction abilities, among other things. So since I've isolated just one frame here, we're going to take a look at this, and we're going to treat it as a photo in LumaFusion, and edit it with pretty much the same results you might in Photoshop or Affinity Photo. You can tell that I have isolated this frame, as I've said before, and we have gone over to this aspect, and we've gone over to where we can add color correction. Now, the preset, Color Saturation 110, is kind of a good place to start. And as you can see, I went from there, all right, and then I messed with it. And the result is up here with what has now become my own personal new preset for this type of photo editing. Now, some of the differences between that first preset and this preset are fairly basic, but you can tell that I have messed with the color levels a bit. You can also tell that I bumped up the contrast. I like that. Now, I bump up the contrast as well, just to give a little edge to the photo, a little clarity, okay? And of course, I bumped from 110 to 117, just to give it that surrealistic look. So now you've modified the frame you want, and it's looking good. What else can we do with it with our limited skills at this point? I think you'd be surprised. Let's take a look at just what we can do with it with one simple tool. Okay, so the few and only lessons that I got on drawing was given to me by my Uncle Dean when I was 5 years old in kindergarten. He taught me how to draw the shape of a head, how to draw it from a quarter turn, side view, to understand perspective. This was like a magic carpet ride for me. But then he started using smudging techniques with his pencil, and I could see color variations in the varying grays of the pencil. With real dark lines, he could indicate black, and the barely smudged was the whites. Now, I learned to blend all of that, and many of us have sketched or doodled and done that, and you get the familiar darkened smudge on your thumb or whatever index you're used to using, right? What we're gonna do tonight is pretty much exactly that, using the smudge tool. I'll give you a couple of hints on the best way to approach smudging when you try this on your own. What is smudging, and what is the smudging tool in Procreate? Well, the smudging tool is very easy to access, and this is just a simple demonstration of what it does and how it reacts to the lines that you may have drawn or the media of which you are going to smudge, okay? So let's take a look at this. So right here, I've just put three black dots, okay? And I did that with this. I could make a fourth one, just that easy. So now we're gonna go up here and change to the smudge tool, okay? And all you have to do is go over there, hit it, and pull it. Okay, so there you can see the trail. It's just like if you had made an ink mark or a lead mark on a piece of paper and you rub your thumb across it. So that's all we're doing here. And you do that by coming across and activating it by pressure of your finger, your Apple pencil, or even your trackpad. Okay. Comic book artists use this trick all the time, okay? I've seen this trick to demonstrate a cannonball being shot out of a cannon. This is an old comic book artist trick on how to demonstrate a time lapse. If you give this picture a second look, you'll notice that one of the balls is more in real time and the others are less real time the further they go. The smudging has produced a trail. It's almost like seeing a cannonball being fired out of somewhere, right? You see the smoke, right? And you can actually see it travel across your page, right? So we're not gonna stick around here too much. I don't wanna see what that cannonball is gonna hit. And let's get back to our original image. Okay, so now we've got our photo in Procreate. We've activated the smudge tool. And on the edges of this photo, we start to smudge. All right, now notice we're moving from this direction out, okay? That's important. And also take note that we have blended by colors. We're not coming across up or down or anything. We're trying to maintain the integrity of the colors as it blends across. Now, sometimes we'll make mistakes, and if you've been watching, you'll see where I've made mistakes, and all of a sudden I have too light of a color, I'll bring in a darker color, and then blend it. All of that is your choice. Don't let anyone tell you it's wrong, okay? There are no mistakes in art, only the mistaken perception of those who perceive it. Okay, so through smudging, we've extended the picture a bit, haven't we? Now, of course, you could do this with a clone tool. It'd be much more accurate, but that's not what I want here. I want it to be artistic. I don't want it to be a clone reprinted just to extend the picture. Do you understand what I'm talking about? I want to give it an artistic flair, and that's what we've done so far. Now, what do we do with this file? Of course, we're going to take it from Procreate over to image size as we've done before. But our approach in image size will be a little more practical this time and a little less glitzy. But this is what I mean by a team of apps that work well together on my dock. I need apps that are not only intuitive, I need apps that talk well and communicate well with each other. And so far, these are the apps that I have found that work for me. But we don't have all the answers, and this is an honest question to all of you viewers. Do you have other approaches? Do you have another set or a team of apps? Or do you have some of these apps, but you team it up with other apps? We want to hear about it. I want to hear about it. And I definitely will look into it. If you've got a better idea, that's what the whole channel is about anyway. All right, let's continue. Okay, so we're in Procreate and we're gonna send this file off to image size just like the way we have before. All right, Now, one of the things we didn't highlight is once it's an image size, you can resize that, take a look at it, make sure it's all detailed the way you want. Now, here's where we go straight to the serious tools in image size. But instead of that very simple banner that we created in the past video, this time our banner expands, doesn't it? So we're going to choose lettering that goes well with that expansion. Now we take great care in how we position this. We want to make sure that the lettering stands out and yet not crowding things in the photo, okay? And we get it positioned just the way we want. Now we're going to add additional text, okay? So we're going to do it in the same fashion and we're going to observe the same rules. We don't want to crowd anything in the photo, and we also want to highlight the figure in the center. Okay, so this time with the wider banner, we can give more information. So we're letting them know much more about the channel than our first previous banner. And of course, we put that off to the side. We don't want to crowd any of the focal points in the photo. And of course, we add our mantra, subscribe to the tribe. But note here, we're going to take a slight left turn and we're going to use the color yellow. We want this one to stand out. It might be the first thing that they see. If they do see that, they will naturally gravitate for the extra information provided in the banner to see if they even want to consider to subscribe to your YouTube channel. Okay, so now we go to YouTube Studio. We go down to customization. We hit branding, okay? We go down two fields, and there's where we can apply our new banner that we saved in image size to photos. So now we hit photo library, we pick our banner, and we take a look at it. Slightly misplaced. Like I said, we're just doing guesstimations at this point and just kind of playing with it like we're in kindergarten. Okay, but this is fun for me. I don't know about you. I love playing with things and cutting things up and putting colors on top of colors for collages. I love that stuff. Okay, so we're close. We're gonna go ahead and try this one. Okay, so once again to photo library, we choose, and that's almost what we want. Okay, so this may take a couple of tries, but have fun at it. Don't get stressed. When you do, go ahead and hit that button to establish it. Then take yourself out of YouTube Studio and bring yourself just into YouTube proper. When you access your channel, you'll see your new banner. And there it is, at the top of all your content, giving all of your subscribers or potential subscribers the information they need. Okay, so that's the basic tutorial of just using one of hundreds of tools you can use in Procreate. We are going to be exploring Procreate more as we go along, and of course, LumaFusion. So please, if you got anything out of this video, give us a thumbs up, and don't forget, we're looking for our first 100 tribal elders. So consider subscribing. Hit subscribe to the tribe, and don't forget to hit that top bell notification, and you'll not only be notified of all future tutorials, but product reviews, product shootouts, and road trips. So a big thank you to all 68 of you tribal elders out there, and I'd like to give all of our viewers the open invitation to go ahead and join our family. I'm Michael Nolan, this is The Bottom Line, and we'll see you in the next video.